Good evening, and today we have our old friend. I mean, Dr. Anjali was on our show, but you know, there was some technical issue, so we couldn't continue that. After a long time, we got an opportunity to connect back, and Dr. Anjali Agarwal is a consultant physiotherapist. Apart from that, she is also a lifestyle consultant, and she mentioned she is something related to heart manual facilitator. We'll check out what it is, but thanks a lot, Dr. Anjali, for joining us today. And she is here to talk about women's health, you know, most importantly, and about postpartum, is that
Part.
Right? Yeah, so she's going to talk about that. So over to you, Anjali ji. Before you start, the friends who are watching this would love to know about Dr. Anjali first, so that we know your journey, why you took, you know, physiotherapy as your practice. And you know, how what's your specialty and all that, and then we'll get into this particular topic. So maybe a quick introduction about you, Dr. Anjali, and then we'll get onto the topic. Over to you.
Thank you so much, and Work TV and Ravi, you've always been doing such great work. A short talk about myself is I had a lot of family members as doctors. You know, like they were busy all around the year, we would hardly see them or talk to them. So when I was choosing my kind of career, like what you would become and all, I always wanted to do something for helping people. It was like coming out of from your heart, like, you know, you need to help people or save lives, something like that. Pehle bachpan mein, I want to become a cardiologist. Then my field about saving a heart became a very passionate affair for me. So a lot of my cousins who were doctors, like they said, physiotherapy is something very evolving field when I took that field long years ago. So I went on to a college which is known as the first medical college which was set up by the Britishers, you know. Jab British wahan the Calcutta mein, to usko presidency jail ke naam pe bola jata tha. It was like a presidency jail. So they turned that into a hospital, and Queen Victoria, King Edward, everybody used to be taking care, you know, medical help, everything was done there. So that was the first and the oldest physiotherapy college of India, I would say. It started there, and that's where I took my training, being a physiotherapist, which is mainly about, now we see in today's generations, more about being more healthier, being fitter and having pain-free life and more, had more momentum in your life with that. So after my physio, I had this passion of like, I had my senior, super senior who had gone to UK to study further. So I always had this passion to go to London or, you know, do my specialized training over there. So for a year or so, I worked with Apollo, which was in Calcutta, and had a lot of trainings with, you know, the cardiac surgeons. I did a lot of work in cardiac rehab. So when people have bypass or when people have, you know, a stroke or a heart surgery, I would be involved in taking care, getting back into life for them. So they start from the ICU journey to being active, going and, you know, going and shopping for themselves. So that independent role I played for these people. And after that, I moved to UK. So UK journey is fantastic because you don't... you know, they don't treat you as a qualified person in UK. So we have to qualify to become, like, we do registration to work in that country, to be licensed practitioner as a physiotherapist there. So you take up many jobs there to fill up your, you know, bank balance in UK, because you just cannot survive in UK without a salary, because you go there. And I was lucky enough to get jobs in NHS, which is the world's largest health service. So it helped me get a job, because when you are exposed to NHS, which is one of the world's best healthcare in terms of social medicine. So how you treat a patient, that is your skill. But how you make the patient feel is also one kind of a skill set, which I think NHS definitely engraved into me. So, you know, like if a patient is sounding very dull and sorry, so you really need to make the person feel happy at that moment. Then only you get your work done. Like, you know, the patient will follow you that time. And then after that, I've moved back to Hyderabad. It's my country. And I started my career with lot of clinics and outpatient setting where I managed a lot of back pains, postpartum issues, women's health issues, and I've been attached to several corporate hospitals. And I look after a lot of pregnancy care, post-pregnancy care. I've become an advocate for women's health now because after coming back from UK, I see a lot of women undergoing a lot of issues with respects to pregnancy, pelvic pains, or postpartum. You know, like there's total negligence to postpartum. The word postpartum is not in our medical dictionary, it seems, in India or in any other country, I would say. So I became a, you know, advocate as to say that every woman postpartum, like 6 weeks postpartum, needs to see me, needs to get that, you know, tender, loving care. And that's about me. And then thereon, I'm now involved with telemedicine. Pandemic took over the toll of the, you know, the OPD clinic for us. But I've been able to help women all around the world through my telehealth presence. And I think most of the women who will be hearing me today also are there now. So they're all being helped online.
Superb. Superb journey. So Dr. Anjali, as a layman, you know, as a common man, when main abhi tak yehi sochta tha ki physiotherapy is only about when somebody gets fractured, and after that, you know, it's like the entire body, or you know, the hand or a lug which gets fractured is in the hands of physiotherapist. So what you're saying is, even I mean, this is news to me. I mean, I'm also hearing this. So even after a heart attack, somebody has a cardiac arrest, after that, you know, they need a physiotherapist, and somebody has delivers a baby, even after that, there is a physiotherapist required. Okay, this is news. I'm learning this for the first time.
Good.
So yeah. Why heart attack? What happens generally? They're in the bed and then they get discharged, right? So are there any complications where they for them to start their normal life?
Yeah, so you know, heart is also a muscle, basically. Agar, like in the times when you get hurt or injured, you get rest, right? So heart also rest after a surgical intervention or after a heart attack. So heart muscle deteriorates with rest. You know, it's not functioning optimally. So with our help, with cardiac rehab, what we do is we get the heart to work in a fashion which is, you know, optimum for anybody to work. And adequately, like suppose I want to walk to the garden, 10 steps to the garden, I should be able to walk without panting or without feeling suffocated or without feeling that I'm losing my consciousness or breath. So to a person who have got a heart which is injured, in layman term bolungi ki heart abhi kamjor hai. Ab kamjor heart ko mere ko majbooti dalni hai, to we are there. And because we skilled medical professionals in the sense, we know what your heart rate should be or what your pulse rate should be, what your breathing rate should be for an optimum heart to function so that aap thodi si exercise kar paye. Exercise matlab ghar ke thode kaam kar paye, cooking kar paye, shopping ja paye, apne kaam pe ja paye. So return to work. So we make you independent after an episode of heart attack or bypass surgery. So going forward, abhi COVID mein kya ho raha hai? It's a lot of issues are attached with heart. ओके तो हम लोग का रोल बहुत सामने आ गया है एज पीपल हु हैव बीन होल्डिंग हैंड होल्डिंग द कोविड द पोस्ट कोविड पीपल फॉर रिहैबिलिटेटिंग देम टू नेचुरल वेज ऑफ लिविंग अ लाइफ सो दैट दे कैन मेक अ कप ऑफ टी विदाउट फीलिंग ब्रेथलेस बट देर आर वेज ऑफ इट सो वी टीच देम टेक्निक्स एंड वेज अराउंड हाउ दे कैन होल्ड अ कप ऑफ वाटर यू नो होल्ड अ कप ऑफ वाटर मे बी पीपल आर गोइंग ब्रेथलेस नाउ That's the biggest complication which we are seeing post-COVID. More of affecting the heart issue. So, हमारा ये role बहुत होता है heart में. And for women's health, women may be एक organ है, right? The pelvic floor. And as the woman delivers the baby, that muscle and the entire body, it's like a rebirth of the new body, I would say. It's a rebirth of a new woman. And that causes a lot of issues. So, we will have to get her back on her feet to doing things which she used to enjoy, right? पहले के concept में क्या था? Women बोलते थे, okay, बच्चे कर रहे हैं, बच्चे हो गए, अब मैं, चाहे पेट है मेरा, चाहे मेरे कोई problem है, urine leak है, urine continence है, okay, fine, I live with it. You know, a lot of women meet up together, they say, you have this issue, I also have it, come on, live with it, because you've delivered a baby. उन्होंने इसको न्यू नॉर्मल समझ लिया है, बट इसका आगे भी सोल्यूशंस हैं. वी लाइक मी बीइंग अ वुमेन्स हेल्थ एडवोकेट, वी हेल्प वुमेन टू बी एबल टू लीड अ नॉर्मल लाइफ पोस्ट प्रेगनेंसी टू. सो दीज आर लिटिल थिंग्स विच वी हेल्प वुमेन एंड द जनरल पॉपुलेशन विद.
Yeah, because most of the women, I think, after the delivery, they only consult the doctor or the gynecologist who's supported them in the delivery. Uske baad, I have not heard of anybody approaching a physiotherapist or, you know, doing any of the exercises which will ensure that they don't have further complications.
Correct. So, France mein, like if you look at countries like France, they have a concept like a 9-day holiday for a woman post-delivery. So that 9 days she spends in the hospital actually. And that is dedicated to her postpartum rehab, which is done by the physiotherapist. Okay, and French government covers that cost. They give that women that royalty to enjoy that luxury, to be pampered within the hospital setting. But apne countries mein kya ho gaya, a lot of private players and public players, maternal health pe jada focus has not been given that way, you know. Even if we decrease the levels of maternal deaths, that will be a big achievement for us. But going forward, I think every woman has the right to go back and spring back into action what she was pre, you know, like pre her conception. So, sabko jeene ka shauk hai aur sabko jeena chahiye acche se, and like in a healthy way.
So, this should be proposed to the policy makers here, the government, so that this is pretty interesting.
Yeah.
Because we all wait for the mother to get discharged as soon as possible, but I think that is more damaging. The expectation of mother coming back, matlab 3 din normal delivery, I think it takes a week or 10 days for a C-section. And the family is all inclined to... जल्दी लेके आओ, जल्दी लेके आओ घर को. या बेबी मोर इंपॉर्टेंटली, आई थिंक दे आर वेटिंग फॉर द बेबी रादर देन यू नो लेस वरीड अबाउट द मदर. दिस इज इंटरेस्टिंग. आई थिंक सम ऑफ दीज फैक्ट्स आर लाइक हिडन. दैट्स वन ऑफ द रीजन वी वांट टू यू नो डिस्कस अबाउट दीज थिंग्स वेयर यू नो दीज कम इन टू लाइमलाइट. दीज आर डिस्कस्ड ओपनली, दीज आर गिवन इम्पॉर्टेंस, एंड दीज कॉन्वर्सेशंस हैपन. And you know, people like next time somebody is delivering, I'm sure I can, you know, have this conversation saying that, hey, don't rush.
So, yes,
because I'm an expert. So hey, I've been through a show with Dr. Anjali and I'm an expert now. So
yes, you know, like body needs to recover emotionally also. As a mother, you have a new responsibility. So she doesn't like understand and she cannot like time it up, like her health, her responsibility for the kid, everything coming together is like two time bond for her. So I think she needs that tender loving care those days after her postpartum.
True. Whether the government is supporting it or not, I think every husband should be aware of it and ensure that this is taken care of, saying that, hey, my wife is not coming back until, you know, this, she completes that 9 days or 10 days of rest, you know, in the hospital with proper facilities where it doesn't look like operation theater and a lot of patients around, but a happy atmosphere, and then she's coming back.
It's more about give them a feeling of that they're in the house, but they're being cared for. Pehle, if you look at Ravi, pehle ke jamane mein, like in the olden times when our grandparents were there, when delivery used to happen in the house, no one went to the hospital. Okay, so what used to happen then was a lot of women got a lot of rest in the mother's house. It was a joint family. Now with nuclear families, the women deliver in the hospital, they go back home, and all the responsibility of the house, the baby, everything is on her. You know, many, many multitasking women, they have the issues of returning back to work also sooner. You know, like if you're a women entrepreneur, you would want to get back to, you know, working again. Right?
Yeah. Even though mother is not working, or the wife is not working, even the husband who is working, he is like, okay, 3 din leave le liya, this is bahut hai. You know, his intentions like, you know, grow back saying that mere ko office jaldi jana hai and all that. So I think he also, because of the career pressure, he also put in a lot of pressure to ensure the wife is back so that he can get back to normal.
Very true, very true.
So why did you choose women health as one of the topics today? Why specifically women? Why are you ignoring men like us?
I would say that the hand that rocks the cradle rules the world, right? And if I say that if you give education to one man, we won't achieve a lot. But if you give education to a woman, she'll make a difference to the whole generation. So women's health is the pulse of every country now. I think it's a sustainable goal which every country and every policymaker should look at. So if the women of the house is happy and healthy, your entire house will be happy, right? So I see a lot of women now during this pandemic, especially I am having a lot of love for these women because they have been, you know, pregnant moms, which I have been seeing a lot of them online and doing all the household work and the office work all alone because most of them, they don't have the people coming from outside to help them because of the risk of exposure. But look at them, how strong these women have been mentally and emotionally during the time of pandemic and giving birth in a hospital. You know, you are exposed, right? But they deliver the baby and they brought the baby home. So it's the whole thing about women, how she's able to handle the stress. And if I don't talk about women's health in this 2021, I think going forward, we really have to make our own mark once again. You know, Women's Day is round the corner. I think all policymakers, everybody who's hearing me should, you know, put their whole foot down and look at women as the whole sustainable goal for any country. So you keep the women happy, the country is happy, and the home is happy.
Superb. So, you know, with respect to women's health, you know, who are your clients? Like, you know, who are the people who come to you, come to your clinic for Dr. Anjali's guidance? What sort of issues do you handle? And what's your specialization? Like, compared to other physiotherapists out there, what is Dr. Anjali really good at?
So I'm known as the magician for pregnant women who have pelvic pains or women who have postpartum urine incontinence issue or something called diastasis recti. So, you know, every time a woman with pregnancy has a pelvic pain, I get called up. Anjali, can you please help? Because, you know, pregnancy is the time you can't give them any painkillers and no other modalities are used on a woman which are safer for the baby. So at times I have a technique where I let this woman, you know, correct the pelvic, we realign the pelvic and thereby the pain just reduces like in a second, fraction of a second. And the women might be dealing with this pain from long, long terms. And many of them are not aware also. You know, like I went to the doctor, I told I have a pelvic pain. The doctor said, it's okay. You know, during pregnancy, all women have this pain. But I always tell women there is definitely, you know, optimum position for the baby or the fetus in your uterus, which gets compromised and when your pelvic organs get imbalanced. And that's when the pains kind of resurface for women. So I just look at controlling that aspect for them. And if the pain is controlled, the pregnancy is very healthy. Any pain which is coming during pregnancy will affect the women emotionally too. So if we take away the emotional pain and the physiological pain, also the physical pain, women's happy pregnancy is a happy baby, I would say. So that's what women call me for. And that's the major, I would say, the skill set which I think I carry forward. And postpartum, I look at women's tummy. You know, like there's a thing called mummy tummy or the mummy pool.
Yeah.
So women bolti hai, mera pet nikal aaya hai. Wo log sochte hain ki it's a tummy fat. Okay. But it's not actually a tummy fat. If we look at majority of the women in this generation, jo bas 24 ghante chair pe baithti hain, the rate of diastasis recti, the incidence of having this problem has increased multifold over the time being when our mothers or our grandparents were there. Because women were very active then. They used to sit on the floor. They used to do all the tasks during pregnancy. They never dealt pregnancy as a disease for so. But nowadays, women with a lot of desk jobs and sedentary lifestyles, they can tend to sit in one position. So the core muscles are very weak. And diastasis recti is like where the tummy muscles, there are two muscles in our tummy, which is called rectus abdominis. It separates out. And it happens after pregnancy and during the pregnancy. And it happens to every woman during the third trimester, which is the last 3 months before she delivers. And that's the time the baby pushes more on the linea alba, which is a thin structure which gets split apart. So many of the women who are not maintaining good posture, good nutrition, good sleep, and not able to take care of their, you know, multivitamins and their stress hormones, they all get affected with the diastasis recti. And postpartum, a six-week check by a gynec is very essential, which many of these women just miss out. You know, they think, okay, baby to ho gaya and I don't bother. Let me just not go to the gynec and get it checked out, or go to the physiotherapist and get checked out. So when these women come to us, then only we know that the tummy muscles can just sink in. You know, it's like I'm in a flight. I don't have windows in the flight. So I'm sitting in a flight which doesn't have window. What will happen? I'll fly out of the window, right? In simple layman terms. So diastasis recti mein kya hota hai, apne organs ko support karti hai, jo muscles, wo, you know, separate ho gayi. It's like a window has opened. So all the organs starts to pop out from there. There's an increased pressure in abdominal wall. And that causes a lot of issues with your pelvic floor. So a lot of women will have a lot of back pain. Many women have constipation. Many people will have bloating. Khana kha rahe hain, gas aa rahi hai, like, you know, like acid reflux, something like that. And then they'll have this chronic pain in the knee joint also. Multifaceted problems will come from one issue, which is called diastasis recti. So a lot of women, especially in the city of Hyderabad, and now with online, I've been able to support a lot of them online too. So we help the women recover, get back those muscles and cure that tissue. So once they are healed, you are a much better person to go back and return back to exercise.
Super. This is good. So they don't have to go for liposuction and all that.
No way. No way. There's nothing like you need a, you know, surgical intervention when a woman has delivered a baby.
Okay.
You know,
tell me one thing, Dr. Anjali. I mean, is this only for, you know, women who just got pregnant and couple of months or, you know, couple of months old, you know, motherhood? Or, you know, is it also for, you know, somebody who's like, you know, ignored it? They couldn't meet Dr. Anjali then and, you know, didn't show, see this particular show. So they missed out a couple of years, 5-10 years later. Can they still do it?
They can still do it. So I have so many, Ravi. They can still tuck in
this particular belly which is popping out.
Pardon?
They can still tuck in. I mean, you said like it can still go back, right?
Yeah. So I have a lady who's 70-year-old. She was coming to me with a bad back pain, which was never going away. She has had multiple surgical interventions on her spine, on her knee. Bahut sare problems the unhe. Or constipation was something which was never ending for her. So when I saw her, only problem she had was diastasis recti, which is the abdominal muscle bandhi nahi hua hai. Right? So that years, you know, like long, long years ago, nobody knew about this condition. Now this diastasis recti, maybe I might be the one who would have brought this subject matter to Hyderabad, I would say. Now people are picking it up as a skill set. But what I would say is that time when every woman is having knee pain or hip pains, I think just ruling out diastasis recti is the biggest trick to her help. If you want to help any woman, any age, I would say, postpartum, that is the key thing to look at. So ruling out diastasis recti for any woman is very important. And that's called as the core or called the pelvic floor also.
Yeah.
So we have been helping her and it's been 2 years she's been with me and she's pain free. She's able to do her task, you know, without getting dependent on a, you know, a maid or somebody. She's able to go to the kitchen and make a nice wholesome meal standing for 1 hour. Earlier, she would be like totally bed bound. Like her pains are so debilitating. Her knee has been operated. Her spine has been operated. But the only problem which was there was diastasis recti.
Awesome.
So that's what I want to raise awareness that if you get your tummy treated, whichever age you are pain free.
Okay. Thanks for clarifying that, because this is really required, because a lot of people might assume that, okay, I've been like a mom since like 10 years, 20 years. Abhi kuch nahi ho sakta. This is God's gift. My husband has to live with it. So,
no.
you know, This is good. This is a good knowledge that people should share. And knee pains, you know, I think that's been a common issue for most of the women out there. So I think they should also get this checked.
Yes, sure.
So how do you determine that that is the only thing if there is a tummy which is popping out? I mean, do you do any tests or how do
Yeah.
you clarify to a woman saying that, hey, this is the issue. It's not, obesity or something else.
So there's a different way we test a woman. We make the woman lie down and she can just fold her knees. Okay. And when she tries to raise her head up, she might put her hand near the belly button. And that, as soon as she puts the belly hand near the belly button, either the belly pops out like a mountain. So it's called doming of the tummy. The tummy domes like a dome. Or when you put your hand in, the tummy just sinks in to a level where I can almost touch her organs, you know. एवरी वुमेन जो भी मेरा शो सुन रही है आपका शो देख रही है दे कैन डू द सेल्फ असेसमेंट एट होम ऑल्सो सो जस्ट लाई डाउन विद योर नीज फोल्डेड ऑन द बेड ट्राई टू रेज योर हेड अप एंड पुट योर हैंड नियर द बेली बटन इफ यू फील द टमी इज डोमिंग लाइक अ डोम और योर टमी सिंकिंग इन यू हैव डायस्टेसिस एंड दे कैन बी लेवल्स ऑफ डायस्टेसिस दे कैन बी ग्रेड वन ग्रेड टू ग्रेड थ्री सो ग्रेड थ्री में कुछ है ही नहीं मसल है ही नहीं बिल्कुल फट गई है Grade 1 is muscle is there, but there's a slight gap which can be repaired. But I work with all grades. I don't believe in grades. I have a lady who had traveled from US. US mein pelvic health physio is very difficult, you know, financially also, and going and getting an appointment is very difficult. So she nearly stayed here for maybe 2 to 3 months and got this problem sorted. She just had a tummy like a grain, you know. Tummy ko uthao, kuch nahi hai. It's like grain. Of sand. And when you have that kind of thing, we always feel that the only option is surgery, you know. But the surgery also was not an option for her because there was nothing to stitch. So slowly and gradually we built her strength back in the tummy. And thanks to whatever she's doing now, she's in back to US now. And she's a happy lady, happy mom.
Superb. So you are making moms beautiful,
Beautiful and healthier.
beautiful and healthier, and making sure that they look good, making sure that whatever that वो रहता है ना मॉम के बाद, दिस इज द फिगर आई विल गेट, एंड दैट डिसअपॉइंटमेंट. सो आई थिंक दैट्स टेकन केयर ऑफ. सो एंड most importantly, I think this particular thing will help them a lot with respect to other issues like knee pain and other side effects. Wo nahi rahenge. So what you're saying is this is a long-term thing, right? So this is not quick. Yeah, ye nahi ki 1 ghante mein checkup ho gaya and then they go back. They need to put some efforts, and this takes couple of weeks or months or year based on which stage they are in. And you're saying there is no medication which is involved in this.
There's no medication.
So they're not taking any toxic medicines to get back to shape.
Yeah. So as I said that I've had patients who have had abdominoplasty, like abdominals have been stitched, ये गैप को सिलाई लगाई गई है, and then they have come to me. The thing has opened up in 3 months. Okay, so the whole game is diastasis recti is not, you know, it's not a cosmetic thing. It's more of a physiological issue, right? So it's your core, your back muscles, your abdominal muscles, your diaphragm. They work like a core, you know. They work like a pura package deal hai. They are like a team together. So one team is off, your muscles will never come together. Even though if I put a cosmetic stitch on it, it'll break apart because the, you know, if I have a wall, there is a force of flood water coming. The flood water will just wash away that wall, right? Even if I have 2 to 3 brick walls laid over that water. So the force of the water will determine whether the wall will stay or not. So if the force on the abdomen content is not being reduced, you know, practically, physiologically, no amount of surgical intervention will help in these cases. Liposuction करना है, टमी को ट्रिम बनाना है, यू वॉन्ट टू लुक मेक इट लुक अट्रैक्टिव, दोज आर अदर ऑप्शंस. बट इफ यू हैव अ हेल्थ इश्यू वेयर मसल्स आर फिजियोलॉजिकली नॉट वर्किंग, यू नीड टू एड इन द फिजियोलॉजिकल हेल्प टू इट.
Does this also include yoga to get this
So no. So we don't give
certificate?
any yogic asanas in these cases because there are a lot of do's and don'ts attached with this program. So we don't ask the women to do, you know, article trend of women do sit-ups. Okay, let me do 20 sit-ups. I have a big tummy. Wrong concept. It's a myth, actually. If you do sit-ups, your tummy is not really going to shrink away. Rather, your muscles or the core is going to get more, you know, damaging effects in the long run. But, and then women do this bhujangasana. Again, the tummy pops out. So these are do's and don'ts. And there are a lot of several techniques which we work on, mainly on the breathing, you know. Women is very stressed out, she does shallow breathing, you know, like they pant, like, you know, aap bhaag rahe ho, like suppose you are running, you know, you see a cat, you see a dog or a cow or anybody running, you see how they pant slowly. So, or if you see a tiger running after you, you try to run very fast and try to go out of breath, right? So that what happens to a postpartum mom and a, you know, prenatal mom. So whenever she's pregnant, weight of the baby in the tummy doesn't let her breathe well. And when she delivers also, she's all around the house doing a lot of things. Multiple times she has to feed the baby. All that takes a toll on her mentally and physiologically. So wo breathe karna bhul jaati hai. You know, the simple formula for sorting this problem is breathe well during pregnancy and breathe well after postpartum. Your problems will be solved. Simple thing, breathe.
Breathe.
And breathe nicely and full, like hawa ko aane do, like, you know, you breathe with
koi jaldi nahi hai, baby aa jayega, bahar aa jayega, baby aa gaya hai, baby koi jaldi,
yeah,
so just breathe. Good. Pehle kyun nahi mili Dr. Anjali aap?
So, sab log mere se ye poochte to zarur hai.
Kyunki, you know, not that I'll be, you know, watching all the women's tummy as to who will need this and, you know, recommend. But yeah, anybody I do come across, I think this is something I'll definitely suggest. You know, doesn't matter what age they belong to, because it should, you know, help out long term.
Yes.
So, or yeah, what are the other, you know, we were talking about myths. One of the myths is the abs thing, you know, it's all across any social media you see, you know, you have these abs, you know, 5 minutes ab, 10 minutes ab, or 10 rounds, 20 rounds, you'll get back to shape. As a, what are the other myths which will save women from, you know, getting their body into you know, much more complications?
Yeah. So suppose you are postpartum, you've had a C-section, or if you had a normal delivery, all your workouts are defined as per your body type and as per your, you know, condition. Whether you have a C-section or a normal delivery. अब ये जरूरी नहीं है कि normal delivery हुई है तो आपके complications नहीं हुए हैं. कभी कभी you have lot of issues with pelvic floor issues, you know, you have a tear down there. So you, anybody who's into exercising or wants to go back to, you know, reducing weight or something, they need to have somebody who's highly professional in the skill of judging what exercise will fit you. So, आजकल women, I always have this women, okay, मेरा tummy को आप ठीक कर दोगे ना, I'll lose weight, right? I'll lose weight. I said, you know, I'll make you functional. What does a functional woman mean? I'm not having pain. I'm not able to, you know, I'm not rushing to washroom every 2 minutes. Or I'm not, you know, kind of leaking when I walk or when I run or when I laugh. A lot of women have the stress incontinence, cough. When they cough, they have a urine leak. And they think it's normal. It's not normal. It's something quite abnormal. If you are leaking, it's not a normal thing. You need to get yourself sorted out with a pelvic floor physio and get yourself going with your life, you know, in a normal way. You don't need to be dependent on diapers. You know, many women say, "Main diaper pehnti hu because this is the issue." I said, you know, you don't need to live with a diaper. You need to have a functional body, make it functional. But cosmetically looking good and functionally looking good is different.
It is different.
Right? 5 minutes ab. कभी नहीं हो सकते हैं, बिकॉज यू नीड टू ईट राइट, योर हॉर्मोन्स नीड टू बी गुड, यू नीड टू बी स्लीपिंग राइट, एंड देन ओनली यू विल हैव अ बॉडी विच इज फंक्शनली फिजियोलॉजिकली गुड. 5 मिनट्स कॉस्मेटिक आई कैन हैव, यू नो, आई कैन डू अ मेकअप ऑन माई बॉडी एंड आई कैन लुक फैंटास्टिक, बट दैट 5 मिनट एब्स आर जस्ट अ मेकअप फॉर योर बॉडी. इट इज नॉट अ फंक्शनल मेकअप फॉर योर बॉडी.
सुपर. सो एनी क्वेश्चंस फॉर डॉक्टर अंजलि व्हाइल शी इज लाइव, फील फ्री टू आस्क. In the meanwhile, we have Teja Gudluru who's saying, good to see you, Dr. Anjali, here on this platform. So,
hi
from Teja. So, or kya hai? I mean, how expensive is this? I mean, is this really expensive for, you know, them to, you know, consult Dr. Anjali first, and baad mein, yaar, no, this is something pretty expensive, I should not be getting into it, or it's a treatment, or I would say a program which a middle class, you know, women can afford.
Yeah, I think it's a very affordable program if we look at the Indian context, you know. This kind of physical therapy field, women's health area, is a very specialized branch, which comes mainly, you know, like you go to UK or you go to US, you'll say, oh yeah, we have a women's health PT and we have a pelvic floor PT and it's an advanced care. Usme, you know, it's the price listing is that way. But in India, we make it very affordable for anybody and everybody to come and get that care and love from us. Because I feel our motto is to help as many women lead a very functional life. Yeah.
Is insurance part of this? Does insurance cover this?
Yeah. So if they have delivered and they have just come straight to us for postpartum, insurance definitely covers for 6 months. You know, the 6 months postpartum care is covered by them. But going forward also, I think many of them, they work in offices, like if they're working in offices, right, which they, because the back pain can be, you know, very close together to diastasis rectus, so they can get it covered. Yeah.
Yeah. So good message for corporates out there. So if you have employees who have potential this particular issue, sign up for the program, and I'm sure it would be worth, you have a functional woman employee who's, you know, who was a mother, or who is a mother, and, you know, due to motherhood, she's having some complication, and I'm sure the performance would definitely increase once this is taken care of. Good, nice. Or kya secrets hai, Dr. Anjali, which we are not aware of?
I would say, like, you know, like every working woman nowadays is very high functional. Like, no, the stress hormones are too much for them. You know, like, raat ko neend nahi aati hai. Raat ko neend nahi aati hai, PCOD, they're having delayed periods or not having periods, which is called polycystic ovary syndromes. So I'm talking about just not the postpartum, women's health as a whole. So if you have a PCOD, we have women with a lot of anxiousness and depression. Okay, so if they're working in an office environment, and many times their teammates will say she's very cranky, she's not productive. But look at the fact that she's dominated by the hormones. Okay, so a high functional woman working at all odd hours, not eating at proper timing, not able to go and do her exercises, actually slows down her metabolism. And as a result, she's ending up having these metabolic syndromes, which is polycystic ovaries, hypothyroidism, and they all affect her as a person, as a human being, you know. So what you see, Mr. A, Mrs. A, or Miss A, or Miss B, they're all the same person, but I think the moods will change as per their hormones. So women are more dominated by hormones, and they need to take care of their eating, sleeping, exercising, and stress levels to be a happy person. So they can be more productive. So whether you are at home, you want to be a happy lady at home, or you want to be a happy girl for your parents. You know, a lot of teenagers nowadays, a lot of moms come to my clinic with a lot of young girls nowadays with PCOD, and they have a lot of mood disorders now. So they're like very, very hard pressed on, like, doing things their way. That is because their hormones let them do that in a particular way. And PCOS is the next pandemic, I would say, which is coming for the world. And it's just because we are not eating at proper timing, we are not happy beings anymore. No, like, pehle ke zamane mein, we, our jobs were 9 to 5. You know, you look at that. Our circadian rhythm pe work karte the hum. Like, jab suraj uga, hum uthe. Jab suraj sunset hua, we slept. Or we ate our food and we returned. Like, birds come, fly in the morning, they return back to nest. Now we are all night owls, right? And everybody hearing is also hearing that. You need to be happily involved with circadian rhythm, which is sun and moon. So when the sun is there, rise up and be active. When the moon is there, slow down, sleep, aram karo. Man ko shant karo, dimag ko shant karo, and then you will be very happy as a person. So that is a One thing I want to tell to women is, if you want to be a happy person, follow the circadian earth cycle.
Yeah, not only personally for them, but the entire family, ensure that they preach that saying.
Entire
That.
family should make sure.
Yeah, good one, good one. So, Dr. Anjali, thanks a lot for taking time out and, you know, sharing this awareness program. A lot of them were like completely new. I'm hearing that for the, you know, first time. But I will ensure that I will preach similar things so that, you know, at least 10 to 20 women are getting benefited of this particular awareness. Before we end this show, what is the suggestion you have for women out there? I mean, you being a woman entrepreneur yourself, you're a doctor, you've been, you know, consulting, you've seen a lot of women who are married, you know, pre-marriage, post-marriage. So what is the suggestion you have for women out there who want to do something, but ya to health issues ki wajah se kuch nahi kar pa rahe, ya to, you know, they're hesitant to take the first step?
I think as women entrepreneurs, we have a lot of responsibility on our shoulders, right? We are doing everything ourselves. It's not like we are dependent on a, you know, income or something. So we always worry about the next move, the next day, the next, you know, accounting, and everything is on our head all the time. But I would say, as women, you have to take your me time, and you are important. And you are a beautiful person in and out. And look at yourself, not just trying to work and slog for hours and not getting any productive outcome. So to get a productive outcome, take a me time out. So when you get up in the morning, sit with a cup of, you know, whatever juice or drink or water, simple garam pani piyo, and sit and kind of, you know, retrospect, like kind of see what life has come forward for you. Have a time where you can pace yourself. I talk about pacing in life a lot. So ye har samay nahi ki main aaj panch kaam kar rahi hu ek din mein to main panchon ko panchon complete karu. Have time for the most important task, like maybe two tasks I can do very importantly in the morning, and the less important task in the evening, because my energy levels, you know, drop by then. Divide your day like this. I think that's a wonderful formula I give to a lot of people. You know, pace your life. Pacing yourself is very important. I cannot be running from pillar to pillar and losing out on my energy and losing out on my health, and be an entrepreneur who's successful too. So you are the driving force. You are your own, you know, motivator. You are the only person who is doing, you are the employee, you are the employer. You are your own team. So you get to be happy and you get to be energized by pacing yourself. Slow down at times. Okay? Har samay gaadi nahi badhti rehni hai. Har samay gaadi nahi chalti rehni hai. Kabhi chalao, kabhi dheere karo, and go with the flow.
Superb. Superb. Thanks a lot, Dr. Anjali. A lot of information, a lot of knowledge, a lot of awareness. So, you know, friends who are watching this, we will share the social handles where Dr. Anjali is available, including her number, contact details, and the website where you can schedule an appointment with her. So you, now you know, and you know, now you know the knowledge she has got. Now you know the areas where she can help you out, or your family members who have challenges can approach her. So do connect with her and do share this video if this will benefit at least one person who will get through, you know, get benefited out of the program which Dr. Anjali has. So thanks a lot, friends, for joining us. Thank you, Dr. Anjali, for joining us and, you know, sharing your valuable time. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Shah.